हेलो गाइस, सॉरी, हेलो गाइस, नाउ विल स्टार्ट विद द थर्ड वीडियो एंड दिस इज द लास्ट फ्रेम फ्रॉम दिस कोर्स. सो दिस वाज अ थ्री फोटो फ्रेम्स विद द डाई कट्स एंड डिस्ट्रेसिंग्स. यस, आई लव 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 माय डिस्ट्रेसिंग्स. ओके, सो Now we'll start. Now I'll show you what all the material we require for completing this frame. So of course, glossy accent, sparkling dust from DMC, water spray bottle. This tray, if you don't have this tray, you can go for any copy paper, Xerox paper. Okay. Foam tapes. If you have any one size, even that is fine. You can always cut it from the center. Your tweezer, a sharp pair of scissors. Then you will need some distressing. So for this this particular project, we'll need rip parmesan, then rusty hinge, then wild honey, then pine needle, and the pulpit. Yes, these five. Distressings will require. What I have done here, these are the sentiments. You make my heart smile, and for some moments there are no words, and few teeny mini sentiments. So these are from Penny Black one liner sentiment set, and I don't remember from which sets these are. And I just went ahead and applied this foam tape just for so that I can save some time in the video. Then we need these few die cuts. Yes, in this this frame we required very few die cuts, very minimal. So this is the one, and this is very beautiful. See how beautiful and delicate this is, with the bird and all the small berries. I love this. And then we need these two pieces of this. Then one piece of this die cut. Again, this is a very beautiful stem, and I like this, the shape and the stem. This is really beautiful. So I like this one. So this one and these flowers. We need two of them. Okay, these are two. So yes, this we need. Then we need these die cuts. Okay, these are the frames, circular floor, scalloped circle frames. Again, these I have with the three sizes. One, this is the bigger one. Then the medium and the smallest one. So please do realize that if you can see my all photo frames, previous ones and this one, all have a same size of outer edge. Okay, only the inner circumference is the different. This is small, then this is bigger, and this is bigger. This is the biggest one, and that's how you get this three layered die cuts. So this is there, and then I have this 260 GSM iris paper, which I have scored I'll tell you how I gave this texture to the paper. And all the suppliers, I have already given you all the names in first two videos, and also I'll be mentioning all the suppliers' names in the description box. So please go, please check that. This iris paper, you will get it from CDC, that is Craft Destination Destination Center, Avni Vyas. She is the owner of that, and the chipboard. Even you will get this chipboard with her, okay. And the size of this chipboard is 9 inches by 9 inches. We will require this in the end, so I'll keep this aside. This paper, 260 GSM paper, even this is the same size as your base, that is 9 inches by 9 inches. So what I have done here, I just placed my paper on my scoreboard and I scored in each and every groove till the 9 inches, till the last one. That's it. I haven't done anything else. So you have to score from each and every groove till the end of the paper, and till the end of the paper from both the side. You have to score it from top to bottom and from your left to right in each and every groove, and you will get this texture. Once you are done with the texture, I'll just keep this aside, my scoreboard, I don't require it anymore. You can distress it from this side, from where you have scored, or from this side where you have the raised texture. I'll be distressing it from this side where I have a raised texture. So I'll start with wild honey. Fine needle I'll need, and at the last. I'll just clear my brush and remove what if there are any previous ends. I'll just remove it as much as I can. These are just your regular makeup brushes. You will get it from you will get it on Crafty's Corner, you will get it from iCraft, even you can get it from your local makeup store, from wherever you purchase your makeup. You can go there and you can buy these. Even these are even available on Amazon, and the range is varied, so you will get options. So what I'll do now, I take my wild honey, I rub my brush on ink pad and I start distressing. Nice and slow and circular motion. Small, go for the smaller portions and then go for the bigger portions. Start with small circles. Always start from the small circle. The more you go in a circular motion and small circles to the bigger circles, the less your background will be patchy. And don't worry, even if your background is patchy, there's nothing to worry. We are going to spray some water on it, so the patches will not be visible. I'll just finish all my I'll go by color by color. So wherever and I want this wild honey, I'll first finish my wild honey on all the pieces, and then we'll move to rusty hinge, and then we'll move to red pumice. This is nice yellow golden color, this wild honey. I'm done with on the background. Now I'll take my frames and slowly and steadily, what I'll do, I'll go from inner edge till the center. I don't want to go on the outer side, so I'll just displace it till from inner edges till the center. You don't have to be very precise till the center, just go with the flow. Same way, I'll do my remaining two frames as well. I'll just stick it. This is the last frame, and as you know, this is quite a broad. Yeah, go ahead and do the distressing till the center or more of the center. With the die cuts, okay. I'll just color this flower completely with the wild honey. But what I'll do, I'll start from one edge, okay, for each petal. I'll just start from one edge. So naturally it will give me some kind of a shading. One edge will be dark and the other edge will be slightly light. Okay, so we'll be doing like this. Same goes for this. Just miss there. You can just lightly shift it, so you get better coverage. Okay, now we just have to do it the way we did the first one. Yes. Edge. This gives you pretty very nice kind of a shading. Again, just slightly open this and finish this. Yes. Now I'll take this and I'll just do it. like this. That's it. Done. We are done with the wild honey. I'll just give this. And then we will take rusty henge. So rusty henge, what we have to do is we just take a rusty henge. No, what I'll do, I'll just grab my marker pen. Just a second. Yes, so these are the Zik color, Zik clean color real brush marker pens, and this is the orange and the number is 070. I'll take this and I'll just color them all the berries. I'll just color them with this. So easy, so fun. These are very, very beautiful marker pens, and these are good for coloring. These are amazing for coloring. Yes, I do color my images with these markers, and I do color my images with distress inks as well. And I love both the mediums. With the Zik markers and distress inks, I color my images with watercolors as well, color pencils. I use Faber-Castell, then I have Staedtler's, and I have Kohinoor's. I have quite a range of coloring mediums actually, and I mix match the mediums. I just if I'm coloring with the watercolor, then I add some detailing with the color pencil. So if I'm doing something with distress inks, I use Zik markers with them. So yes, I like to play with my mediums, and I enjoy that. So this is done. We are done with this and with the markers as well. So we are done. We'll add some peel paint to this afterwards. Now I'll add rusty henge to my background. I'll just load my brush with rusty henge and I'll start rubbing it on my background. And don't worry, as you know right now that we'll be spraying some water on it, so all the patches will be vanished with magic. Don't restrict your brush while distressing. We don't want any particular lines, sharp lines on the background, because the sharp lines are quite difficult to remove with the distressings. That line will be there permanently. That's it. Now I'll take my that's it. Red pencil will go for the figures only. Now I'll spray some water on it. I'll just hold my spray bottle at a distance and spray. Mix it. Again, I'm taking my rusty hinge and I'm going over. And now I'll be finishing this edging, and that I'll be doing this rusty hinge applying from all the side. So this is one. Now from this side. And please, please don't restrict, but just don't go till the center. Okay. We want darker edges. Now, third side. I am placing tissue paper under my fingers because I just don't want to, you know, my body oil to transfer to the paper. That happens, it will show from the distress ink. Your distress inks will not sit on your body oil or your lotion or anything, any oily surface, because distress inks are a water based ink, so they will not sit on any oily surface. Again, I'll spray some water on it. Hold your bottle at a distance and spray it. And we are done with the water part. Now my paper is completely dried, there's no sogginess, and I will just flip it so it will get spread. There will be no bubbles. Now I'll take my frames and I'll take my rusty hinge and my tissue and I'll just load my brush with right permission and I'll start coloring it. Now the second one. This time I'm going little inside and more on, I'm focused more on outside edges. I'm not going much inside with this color. Whatever the gap is there, I'll fill it with the rusty hinge. Now the smallest one. This will be more or less of the red permission. Just the edges. Now I'll just remove all the excess color. I take my rusty hinge, load my brush, and from inside I go to the outer side. You see how beautiful this looks? We'll do the same thing for all the three frames. This is the last frame. I'll just load my brush and from inner edge to till the outer edge, I'll go with my rusty hinge and cover our entire area. Once you are done with this, take your spray bottle, separate and fix again. Take your second frame, spray it and set it. If you see that you have some extra water somewhere, just dab it with your tissue. Don't worry about this. This is anyways we will be placing our the small frame over there, so don't worry about it. It will be not shown. It will be not visible. And the last one, just hold my spray bottle at a distance and spray it. Clear my mat and I just wipe out all the water, whatever the residue is there. Perfect. Now I take my foam tip, double sided tip, and I'll cut small pieces out of it and place it at a distance. As because this is a circle, you cannot go and stick one single piece. It will be difficult. So just cut small pieces and stick. Take a second one and repeat the process. be careful. You don't have to cover this entire because we need some space to, you know, slide your photograph. So we don't want to cover the entire circle, this circle. I guess we'll finish here. So this much of space is good enough to slide your photograph. Perfect. Now what I'll do, I'll take my second size and remove all the backing. Apply some glue. Why you are using glue on the tape? So that if I make any mistake by while placing this, I can change my placement of my paper. And it will not damage my paper. That's it. As this is a, you know, this is a scallop and the circle, so this is quite tricky while sticking it. But we are fine. Now the third one, the topmost. Remove all your backing. All the backing paper. Glue. We have one other advantage of adding glue to the foam tape. See, after certain period now, your two-way tape loses their tackiness. So, if we apply the glue, once the tape started losing tackiness. It's your things, your arrangements start falling off. So the glue gives you the benefit, the extra benefit that it sticks properly and your arrangements will not fall ever. Now the base, remove all the backing. Take your base. Oh shit. I need to stick my base to the chipboard. So what I'll do, I'll just quickly add some glue to my base paper. I'll take my chipboard and I'll just match one edge of the chipboard and the paper very nicely. I'll take my tissue and I'll start pressing it. Why I'm doing like this? So that the paper, if there is any air between the chipboard and the paper, the entire air will remove. There will be no bubble, no air bubble, and your paper is completely securely stick to the base. So it will not wobble. Now I'll just take my frame and I stick it here. Just eyeball the center and I'll just stick it. Perfect. Now here. This is the center and this is open. So you can slide your photo here from here. And we have a quite a good amount of opening. So yes, you can do that. So we are done with our base. Now we'll take our die cuts and we'll finish the coloring. I'll take my red permeation, and now for this I'll start coloring from the opposite side. See, if you can see, here is my rusty wild honey, which is a dark side, and now I'll start my coloring from the other side. For each and every petal, I'll do this. Just merge it, okay? Just merge the two colors. We don't have to show, you know, the line here your wild honey is started and here your permeation is finished. No, we don't want that. We'll just do the shading. Perfect. How beautiful this turned out. So beautiful. And the same way I'll do this. Just adding the red parmesan to each and every petal and merging it with the wild honey. Now let's put it. Yes.
Yeah, can you see?
How beautiful this looks. See. A nice color combination. Very beautiful. Once I'm done with this, I'll just clear my brush. And I'll take my these things, these die cuts, these three die cuts, and I'll take my peel paint and I color it. Just go completely, just cover complete face with peel paint. This as well. Oops. Another one. Now I'll take this time I'll take my peel paint and I'll just go over it. Just go over it. Perfect. Now I'll take my pine needle. And I just go lightly over it. I don't want to do it over, so that's it. Now this one, I'll do it. For this, and then this, the last one. I'm not doing this completely, I'm just doing it from tip to till the center. I want to show my peel paint. Perfect. We are done with the coloring part. Now I'll just take this again. And what we'll do, now we'll see how we can arrange it. I'm just doing the dry run. How I can do this, so don't worry. Okay, so, and then we'll add these leaves here and there. So I'll just remove these flowers of mine. I'll take my glue, fabric glue, and I'll put glue somewhere here and there, and I'll just stick this. Okay, and now I'll take this, another part of this. And I'll stick it from here. Okay. I'll just cut all these leaves separate. so that we can stick them wherever and however we want. Nicely cut them one by one. If you are comfortable, you can do this with the hand. Okay. And as a part of this we'll cut them as well. We'll separate them. Perfect. Okay. And we'll cut this short. Yes. Done. So now what we'll do, we'll add some leaves okay. Can I do this? I'll just keep these flowers as I want them to be. Okay. And now I'll place my remaining stuff around them. Why I'm doing this? Because I want my flowers on the top of everything. So I'm just placing my leaves here and there so that green will separate my flowers from the underneath yellow color. It's fine, it's pretty well. Yes. That's the only thing we want. Done. I will add the rest of my berries this side only. I don't want anything with the bird. Now what we can do, okay, this will go here, this will go here, this will go there, okay, so first we'll stick this. Now first we'll stick the flowers now and then we'll see if we require more leaf or not. So put this glue on each petal, not completely, not till the end, because this is going to be hanging more of. So just in the center. Yes. And place it. Okay. Now take the another one. Don't press it hard. If we want, we can change the placement. So don't place hard. Okay. See, I told you we might need to change the placement. Okay. And this one. So this one will be like this. This will go down here and up there and done. So now you can press it quite nicely. Now I have three leaves with me. So what I'll do, I'll put some glue and I'll place one here. This looks quite empty. So I'll place one leaf here. Okay. Something here. And the last but not the least, we'll place it here. So it's way too empty. So we'll place it here. Place it. Nice. And this is how your third photo frame is almost done. And again, I forgot to add sentiments. So I'll take my brush quickly and distress it. I'll do the edging. Take all your sentiments, do edging, and if you guys noticed, we haven't glittered these flowers yet. We'll glitter them. It's just I forgot to glitter them. So first we'll finish it and then we'll glitter it. So what we'll do, we'll remove this. Glue and see where we can fit. Can we here? Yes, we can here. And just you make my heart smile. Okay, good one. The other one. some moments there are no words and I am sticking it from quite a bit of a corner. Okay. Now these chintupindu, I mean small teeny mini sentiments with love. Okay. Where this can be with love. We can stick this here with love. Then we have I love you. This is one of my favorite sentiment. I love you. And this goes here. Then just for you. You are the best. This will stick here. Yes. Now, I'll take my glossy and just add my glossy to all these petals. If you don't have glitter or you don't like glittery look or you don't want glitter everywhere, you can just glossy your flower and leave it as it is. You don't have to apply glitter everywhere. I guess we can even leave it with the glossy only. Yeah, I guess I'll do that. We'll just apply glossy and just leave it to dry and not to add any glitter in here. Wherever you can apply your glossy, just go ahead and do it. This is your third frame, and I'll leave it as it is. I'll just have it with the glossy, not with the glitter. Or should I add the glitter? I'm not able to, you know, decide. But we'll add glitter as our two frames has a glitter. I guess I'll go with the glitter only. So what I'll do, I'll just place a tissue paper underneath. I take glitter and I sprinkle it. Sprinkle over it as much as I can, generously, nicely, so that the glitter will cover the entire flower. This looks beautiful. It's good that I am adding glitter. Okay, perfect. Nice. Just with some dust and a shimmer of it, and I'll just tap it. So all the excess glitter will be removed from here. Yes, done. And I'll just add this in my glitter bottle. So this is how your third frame is ready, and we are done with the course. Thank you guys, thank you for joining me.